today is a special day. I'll be showing you how to make a feeding tube that you can do it on your own, less than 5 minutes. And you can use this feeding tube to help feeding your kids, okay, during this pandemic, so that way you guys can practice at home. If you are a coaches, when you're working with a large number of people, you can also use this. You can ask your student to feed with each other so that way they can practice. Okay, so without further ado, let's get started. So the equipment that you need is, of course, this is a milling tube. You can get this on Amazon. So the diameter for this one is 3 inch. So you want to make sure you get the 3 inch, don't get the 2 inch one. 2 inch is too small, so the bird will stuck. Okay, and this is 30 inch long. Of course, you can get 24, you can get 36 and more, it's up to you. Second, you need your Sharpie, your razor, scissor, glue, you can also use double tape, and your lighter, zip tie. For the zip tie, I'm using the 12 inch. Okay, 12 inch should be enough. You can use 16, but don't go with the less than 12 inch, okay? And then your staples, and also your old badminton bag, okay? Whereas there's a strap, okay? So it doesn't have to be a badminton bag, but of course, if you have a strap that you don't use it at home, you can use this, okay? You can also buy it on Amazon. They sell those straps too as well. Okay, all right, so let's get started. First, you want to open the cap and grab your Sharpie, and I want you to draw a line like how you eat pizza. They have a different slice, so I want you to draw exactly the same. Here, as you notice, there are two layers, okay? The inner layer and the outer layer. Inner layer and outer layer. So what I want you to draw is, I want you to draw from the second layer, second line. So, okay, so just draw like this. I want you to draw about, I would say, 8 slices of pizza, like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yeah. So just like this, okay? And then next, you want to cut them. Okay, once you finish, and then you can grab your scissor, and then you just cut the rest of the line. Like so. Like so, okay. All right, next, I want you to grab your Sharpie again. I want you to draw a circle. I would say about 1 inch diameter. One to one and a half inch diameter from here. See this? And then you're gonna cut them again. Make sure you follow the line. Like so. And then next, you wanna bend. You want to bend it outward, okay? So bend it outward, not inward. Like so. Okay? Next, we're gonna glue using a craft bone glue, or you can also use double tape, double-sided tape, and just glue the edge. You can glue right here. This is optional, okay? So you don't have to glue it, but if you want to secure the cap so that way it will last longer, then I would say it's best that you glue them. Okay? All right, next, from here, what we're gonna do is, you want to grab your old racket bag or grab your strap. So we need to cut them. Okay, so once you cut them, you want to make sure that you burn the edge, okay? So you want to burn them so that way whatever the material is will not coming out, okay? The line or the string right here doesn't come out, okay? Look like so. And then next, what you want to do is just grab your zip tie. Just put it inside the strap right here. Okay. And then you want to secure. And tight. Okay, and then cut the tip. Okay, you finished making one. You see this? Alright, the last one. Grab another. Oh, actually, so you want to lock it first, you want to make a loop, okay? So that way, you want to make it look like this. Okay, next you want to staple the strap like this, like so. And okay, so around it in between. You can hide the zip tie inside the strap, like so. Okay, there you have it. Next, we're gonna slide all the bird here inside. Gonna look like this. Again, you wanna get. Again, you wanna make sure that you get a 3-inch one so that way the birdie can slide easily. Okay, this is how it looks like. Yeah?
Okay, as you can see.
Now let's go to the court and then see how it works.
Thank you.
Alright, I hope you learned something from today's video, how to make the feeding tube less than 5 minutes. And if you like this video or if you learned something from this video, so please hit the like button and share with your friend. And also please subscribe to my channel. And if you have any different way of how to make a badminton feeding tube video, please share with us so that way we can learn from each other. Alright, so I'll see you next time.